Now, welcome back. Yes, I see the Bunge Good Morning Niger show. Just before, you know, we come live, I think I just enter internet more, read more on top of the matter where we say we won't discuss this particular morning. You know, to really confirm if now really law for Nigeria today. But the experts we say we get on the show, we'll break and down for us. Because I shall say, just like other bills, like, you know, social media bill, that time we say come out, they make noise about the matter. Yes. Nigerians make noise about the issue. So I dey wonder how this particular matter take come up, and the usual was not done. We now make noise to question the issue. And now on top of that, they call lifestyle audit. Loretta Onochie, now she been bring this matter up. The talk say she been the tweets say lifestyle audits don't they say the thing now, say the thing don't they legal for Nigeria when we say. You get the kind of flex when you say you go to flex. You know,
watch you.
EFCC.
If you watch you say.
Any graft agency, if you enter, say, Oga, the way you are living is not commensurate with the hardship in the economy.
And what you are earning.
Maybe, maybe we forget what you are even earning first. How you are even living.
How you are living.
Because if I say, Loretta, I never understand the law of packaging yet. But the thing we say, what I'm talking about, we say, he gets you go take package rich, then we'll come after you, you know, to ask you, say, word up, what is really
going on?
Yeah. Well, we get Babajide Ijo, barrister Babajide Idowu, on the line with us. Make we really break down this matter very well. Make we understand waiting day. They see the thing come, then don't pass them into law. What can we expect from this particular matter? Babajide, good morning.
Good morning to you, and thank you for having me on the show.
All right. So I beg, make we enter this Madam Loretta Onochie matter. On top say lifestyle audit is now legal in Nigeria. Now that one, I first hold me pass. She's the media aide to President Buhari. For those who don't know who Loretta Onochie is. Oh yeah, Oga, I beg, explain this matter to us. Then don't pass this one into law, Abi. It just be like Oga Lai Mohammed and the amount when he fixed by himself to find media organizations. Which one be this one?
There's no law in Nigeria yet that will make them legal to do lifestyle audit. You know, so the way that they do things for Nigeria, they go first fly kite, see people reaction. But legally speaking, there is nothing wrong in agencies like EFCC, FIRS, make them investigate the source of your wealth just to find out whether you really worth this amount. So, I mean, even when you read cases in Nigeria, like Gani Kwawemi and I, when the guy wants to Oga Tinubu to a matter, said that even though he had opinion as the governor, that it could still be investigated. So there's another case, I think Daudu and I think EFCC, where the first one civil servant and they try to prove the source of his wealth. The guy they argue say they give the presumption of innocence, and what the court held in that case is that the civil servant, based on your pay, there is a limit to the amount of money you have. And if you cannot detect that amount, then you have to prove the source of your work. So the concept of audits, like the architecture of security agency, is allowed for you to, as a taxman, if you take party, you see person, they spray money. Supposed to investigate that. How much does he have? How much does he have? They take tax. And based on that, you cannot take the conversation. But obviously, there are things you must do.
Sorry to cut you short, because I see waiting, we don't scroll for our TV screen. They say lifestyle audits don't they legal. So make we correct this matter now. Just hearing from you as a barrister, is it legal? Because when I say anything they legal, meaning to say it is part of the law. There is a law backing it. So make we make it very clear one more time. Is it in the law? Is it legal to audit people's lifestyle in Nigeria today?
There is no specific law that allows. However, on the basis of reasonable suspicion, EFCC, police, and to some extent, the tax official, can launch an investigation to find out whether you are, for tax people, you are not evading tax, and for the EFCC, that the source of your wealth is legal. However, it must be within the ambit of the law. So by ambit of the law, the presumption of innocence, suppose they, you know, suppose freeze account without court order.
Meaning to say, if EFCC decide to just pick on me by the way I look, you know, or my house or whatever it is, I get right to go court to contest the matter. Do I?
Yes, if you believe it's not based on reasonable suspicion.
So clearly, I just want to just be very clear, make Nigerians understand. So clearly, it is wrong to say that. So is it wrong or right to say that lifestyle audit is legal in Nigeria?
It is wrong to say, to the extent that you are looking for a specific law way back up. But if police officer see a person of 20 years, they drive Bentley or EFCC, and you know they do any work, if you call out for question based on reasonable suspicion, and if people say, okay, I win one lotto, I get $1 billion, and he has done what he's supposed to do in terms of payment of tax, he's fine. He's supposed to leave him alone.
Okay, barrister, looking at this this situation, it is very, very, it not too strong like that, because if law not day where they back this thing officially, which means say now based on suspicion and just a physical assessment, nine person, nine police or EFCC or tax companies fit come at you. So which means say even if say everything where you they do they all right, and they don't come tell you, so yeah, you go need show us a proof, show us information. That time where you don't spend in doing this process, because as we take note, they've been freeze some people accounts recently based on say they suspect say they get involvement in the past NSAS protest accounts, been they freeze accounts. So if that process they happen, and that time where this individual they spend with these agencies to explain to them, say, now what are they do? Now what are they, would he be compensated for that time that is going to be infringed by these agencies on him? Would there be any form of compensation based on say if they check him or everything they okay, and based on say law not they, we even make them say okay, well, now this law now would they stand on to actually carry out this movement? Anything, you know, they like that.
Yes, we get people who don't challenge things like that for court. So, like I thought, it's based on reasonable suspicion. So if you believe, say, you are being harassed, witch-hunted, or necessarily disturbed, you go court, get injunction, restraining them from continuing harassing. But one thing where we know, say, by the acts where they create police, part of their job is crime prevention. So if you suspect this, someone is about to launder money, someone is laundering money, there's something not add up. They're wrong if you call the person for questioning. So once you follow the law, and I mean, if for instance, they write letters to me say, okay, we want to see you for our home. Mm-hmm. And they tell me, say, which time would they convene? It's different from when you send 15 men to my house.
Yes, yeah, to harass the person.
Mm-hmm. And you now tell me that taking me out today too. So everything about style, about methodology.
Mm-hmm. Okay, before I turn to the next question, I beg my producers, it go good, make we actually just change this particular chess caption. Either we are putting a question mark at the end, make we no mislead Nigerians. Either we go leave them at lifestyle audit, waiting we need to know, or you go put and say, lifestyle audits, don't they legal? Let's have that question mark there, so we do not mislead people on this particular subject. Or can I make, I take my time to really want get that breakdown. Make Nigerians understand, say, you also get right to question the person when they question you on that matter. You get right to me, say, if you don't enter harassment case, if you get your lawyer to say, you know, on what grounds are you coming into my own personal business? To check me out and whatnot. Now, Oga, concerning this whole lifestyle audit matter, you get where, as an individual, if you draw the line, make we start from there. Because, you know, say, audits, they can ask you for anything. Of course, from the job that you do, from your salary, when say, most companies do that salary matter, like courtism case. And like, we don't tell another person waiting to the end. You know, I remember when this NSAS riot happened, and I meet person where we say one of his businesses, then really destroy him for circle more. Mm. When I want to interview the guy about the losses where he gets, the guy said, no, go fit talk. Now, when I ask and say, why? He said, because he no want make people associate him with that particular business because he get work, he get normal office work where he they do, right? Mm-hmm. And for his own, so that one are like side business for him. Mm-hmm. And if in company know what in they do, either maybe there for among him, they're in contracts, right? Mm-hmm. Even if the company is not really into that particular business, or maybe then they tell them say, if you do a particular level, you not fit they do other things by themselves. So for that, he no want, you know, talk. So everybody gets, you know, what they are doing. It is not illegal in a way, but at the same time, they do not want to put their business out there. So where do we draw the line when they don't begin this their audit matter?
As a general thing, I go talk to when they go for things like this. May you go with your lawyer.
Uh-huh.
Mm. So your lawyer will be please step in when necessary. For yourself, but the truth be said, you might not lie, most times they know they don't. But the first thing where you go at is, okay, why you invite me? So if they tell you, say, we're inviting you with regard to, let's say, the car you bought, I am now asking me questions about how my wife bought something else. So you know that you are going clearly out of the line.
Okay.
So based on the allegation of what they are investigating, you'll be able to join the line as regards what they should ask, what they should not ask. So just like all these people to pay the arrest for Yahoo, you can't say because I have a laptop, you are calling me a Yahoo boy or girl or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, there's nothing wrong if the policeman should stop you and ask, where are you coming from? Where are you going to? And if I can show you my ID, I'm coming from Azobia FM. You'll be asking me that I should put on my laptop if you want to tell. So that is clearly invasion of right to privacy. But if, for instance, they've seen, let's say they take your book, they saw $1 million. Obviously, they have to ask you more questions.
Yeah.
Where did that money come from? What are you doing? So the allegation generally determines the line of question and where to draw the line.
Hmm.
Okay.
All right.
All right. So another thing I got to say, one of these issues, why this is very important, besides even individuals, it's also very important for people in this day public office.
Mm-hmm.
I know say a couple of years they're going to be talking that to say people were inside civil service. It go good for you to the study or rather to the observe your own colleagues. Because we know the level of corruption when they happen on top civil service matter.
Yeah.
Say your colleague, because everybody know level by level.
True.
It not be like private business when we say That was salary feel different from my own, even if they do the same work. They tell you, say, now you're part of your bargaining power.
Yeah, yeah.
Now you go fit negotiating power, rather.
Negotiating power,
now you go determine what they carry, they go out. For civil service work, by your level, it is easy to predict
amount with
how much.
Yeah.
So when a particular, you know, colleague of yours for civil service, don't they live one kind of lifestyle where you don't understand? Need a good to chook eye.
Yes, no, at least.
To know whether that side business true, or that person they siphon money. Or Gabarista, this particular issue now, clearly you don't already talk and say there is no law in Nigeria that is backing this up.
Mm-hmm.
But then graft agencies, owing to suspicion, can check in. This person they call them, people weren't there in government at this time, they're susceptible to this particular, you know, rule. You fit, then if you enter,
people with it.
Like
serve,
governors, for instance.
Presently.
As a government official, when you come in, you're supposed to declare your answer.
Which is not really common.
We know they really see that one now. You know they really
Some of them, they do. It's just that they don't come to national
league. Okay, Ide law. Okay, upon saying Ide law, we know they enforce them.
We know they enforce them. As Ide law, so. Wow.
The thing is, not everybody will come out and talk, say, oh, I they go deposit my declaration of assets form for code of conduct
bureau.
Mm.
So not everybody, but I think some people they do them. And well, if we get agency where they work as part of the investigation, they supposed to look those who never submit as that when due. So the law covers them, and that's why they talk. That would be an FRA. That was the. I'm not sure if. Person was a private individual. I mean, I'm not sure if the person was a private individual, if the case might have gone that way. Because you read that case, the case worked there as a civil servant. So there's an amount of money you're expected, and EFCC that the burden on them by showing your salary and the money found in your account more than that amount. So you have to prove that it was through legal means that you got that money. So it covers them, but whether our craft agencies will get political will go against those people, now another discussion. And I think one problem where they don't accuse us of Nigeria, you say we know the question, still wants to see rich man, everybody go on for. So if it's done properly, emphasis on proper, but everything we could for Nigeria, we get way where with the attack. If this they are done properly, it'll be bad.
All right, Barrister Babajide Ido, thank you very much for this better conversation. And it's good, as you take, don't point out this thing clearly, make people know where we stand and how the matter take be. Looking at the clauses here and there regarding this whole situation, we know say some kind of things stiffy happen if they suspect the lifestyle of a certain individual. And we they ask, as you take, we take ask the question whether it go cut across public officials too. And you say yes. So we they wait to see, say, as the matter don't start, so, or as it be so, we will see more active cases where they work, where they lead to, you know, where they conclude. Not be say they go start the matter and they no go end them. Thank you very much for your time this morning, Oga Barrister, and do have a lovely day ahead of you. All right, we just finished the conversation with Barrister Babajide Ido, a legal practitioner. We just discussed this conversation of lifestyle audits, whether he get law. As he don't talk, I'm saying law, not day, where they outrightly put, say, okay, now we think will happen be this. But exceptions day, if the security agencies and anti-graft agencies look the kind thing, the lifestyle where you they live, and they feel looks, okay, for this thing where you they do, we go like check. Within your financial
on top invitation, maybe even on top say harassment.
No, be harassment.
And when the thing they happen, you need to carry lawyer go.
Yes.
So there is no law
backing
this issue up. But owing to suspicion, maybe something done they happen where you say you did connected to.
Then
feel follow up to say, I'll go back, come our office for questioning.
Yes.
Make we just see certain documents to back up A, B, C, D, and E. Now make we'll make that matter day very clear.
So which meaning say all those 15 men raiding houses, you know, suppose they happen be that.
Unless now where maybe like these people don't like the Koyi house now, where they don't get
intel
say money they person back here. That one a different matter. When they say you be CBN, now money just sit inside your house. But to say you see, say person carry bone straight of 50 inches. You understand? And you know, say now office assistant.
You know, say she never get salary.
Now in the person be. Mom say make una just temper justice with mercy. Like I said again, it is not legal. There's no law backing it up. You know, yeah. So
but the exception day.
You don't know whether I borrowed the bone street.
Yes. And then I where the conversation is supposed to start. Say, okay, yes. Tell us about this bone street.
Yes.
Not be say you are a criminal.
Yes.
Bring that bone street. No. Mm. The conversation goes start.
But so the thing go really they very funny because many things now they add tom.
Yes, ma'am.
To make people get money. Nobody gets one income for this Nigeria as it be.
See, where did they get this 1 million?
And if people
from?
Open their mouths, yeah, tell you what so. They do to make the money. Now there the wallah go day. So make the people when one check, waiting they don't send them. May they just set
their ear. May they prepare for waiting
they go here.
All right. Well, the matter be that.